As I surf YouTube, I keep seeing the question, why is the market continuing to go up? And I want to address that. In my mind, there are 12 reasons why the market is going up, and these 12 reasons are converging at one time. To put this into perspective, I want you to think about the city that you live in and what it looked like in the year 1900. There was no infrastructure. Many of the roads were dirt. The means of transportation was probably horseback or horse and buggy. There were no telephones. There was certainly no radio or TV. There were no airplanes. There were no cars. Basically, there were no supermarkets. There was no Kmart. There was no Walmart. There was no internet. There was no cell phone. There was none of the things that you take for granted today. That was 100 years ago. All those things evolved. The assembly line, the telephone, the radio, the TV, the internet. Entertainment was go down to the bar, I guess, and watch somebody sing and dance. And now entertainment has gone through movies, the silent movies, the talkies, the YouTube, virtual reality. Everything has evolved over those last 100 years. And what I'm going to propose to you is that what 1900 looks like to you will be what 2020 will look like to people in 2030. In other words, the development of our country, of the world, of technology will go through 100 years worth of change in the next 10 years. Yeah, I know that sounds ridiculous. Give me maybe 15, but within the next 10 years, I believe. And what are these 12 things that are going to happen? Well, first of all, I got to back you up about 10 years, because you started the ball rolling about 10 years ago when you first signed into Google and you started searching, when you first went to Facebook and you filled out your profile, when you clicked that button that says, yes, I'll give you access to my contacts and my photographs, when you went to LinkedIn and you filled out a profile, when you went to Yelp and reviewed a restaurant, when you went to TripAdvisor and posted your pictures and reviewed a resort that you went to, when you picked up your phone and activated your GPS, or the GPS on your watch, or the GPS in your car. That's when this all started, because that's when you started feeding data into the servers of those providers. And that has now been coined the phrase big data. Someone has in the cloud the data on all of us, including when I get a text from somebody or I get a phone call from somebody, I immediately go in and type their name as a new contact. So I would guess on my phone now I have 5,000 people that I have a contact. That's in the cloud. They know that. When I went to the doctor's office for my lab test, I checked a box that said that they could share that information. That's in the cloud. It's out there on me. When I went to 23andMe and had my genome run, I checked a box that said they could share that. That's out in the cloud. All that big data is in the cloud. Whether you want it there or not, it's there. Every search you do on Google or Bing or Yahoo and every product you buy or every product you look at on Amazon, every Google search you do is out in the cloud. Well, enter the next big change, and that is 5G. We have the cloud filled with data on Carrie. Now the cloud is going to get data on Carrie's house, on his Internet of Things. They're going to talk back and forth to each other, and it's going to change the way world I live in. It's going to bring me autonomous automobiles. It's going to change every aspect of my life, and that's more data going into the cloud on Carrie. The next big thing after that is going to be artificial intelligence. And what that basically means is my intelligence reads my data, thinks of my data, and interprets it one way, but I have a tendency to forget things. And I don't remember, and I don't relate things. Well, artificial intelligence isn't that way. It remembers everything, it correlates everything, and it segregates and separates everything, and then makes decisions and interpretations and anticipates what I'm going to want, what I'm going to do, where I'm going to go. Amazon right now says, with their artificial intelligence, they know with a 60% accuracy what the next thing I'm going to buy on Amazon is before I know I'm going to buy it. That is just going to explode. Artificial intelligence, and within 3 years, I will have an AI. Think of it as an avatar, because within 5 years, I will have an avatar. Something that looks like me, something that feels like me, that can go out into the digital world and represent me. If I wanted to go give a speech in San Diego next year at the, or 3 years from now at the World of Internet, I could send my avatar in my place. He could stand on the stage and I could talk through his mouth. It would look exact. That's artificial intelligence. That's coming. That's why the stock market's going up. Item number three is virtual reality. Entertainment as I know it today is going to evaporate. My TV screen will become a pair of glasses or a pair of goggles. And I won't just be watching a movie, I'll be participating in that movie. I'll be a character in that movie, and I can interact in that movie, and I will feel as if I'm there. I will be able to touch the other people and in the movie and feel them. I will be able to learn through virtual reality by putting me into flow. My ability to learn will accelerate at a rate of about 300%. That is to say, it will recognize I'm dyslexic. It won't ask me to read. It will put me into the situation of learning. And then it will, through artificial intelligence, determine how I learn, what I like, what I don't like. And it will present it in me in such a way where I will go into flow and I will absorb things at a speed that I have never been able to absorb in the past. That's why the market is going up today. Robotics. Robotics are going to come, and it is going to change our manufacturing world. Where we have textiles now being made in Vietnam and China, that's all going to come back here. And those textiles will be made in the United States, and they will be made through 3D printing, which is down the line a little bit, and robotics, and what took 2,000 people to produce in China or Vietnam will take about 20 people to produce here in the United States. That's why the market is going up today. Second is cloud computing. All this data that I'm talking about is in the cloud. It's now being processed and sort it through artificial intelligence to make my life better, to make your life better, to make sure that if another virus comes, we can isolate it immediately and quarantine those people so it doesn't travel. It should have stopped in Wuhan, China. And in the future, it will. And that's why the market is going up. Quantum computing. With all this data, we're now using the computers of the last generation. The new generation will be able to process data at lightning speed above what we're currently processing information. So quantum computing is why the market is going up. 3D printing. 3D printing is again going to move manufacturing to the United States. If you watch the video that I put out on, I believe it's pronounced Nikola, the new trucking company, they are making the parts of those trucks with 3D printers. Tesla is using 3D printers. You will be able to go into a clothing store of your choice and look at a garment on your avatar and say, that's what I want, and I want it in such and such a style or such and such a designer, and they will have a 3D printer with 4,000 needles in it in the back room, and you'll come back in 2 days and have that garment, and it will fit you perfectly because they placed it on your avatar. That's why the market is going up. Alternative energy. We are going to get away from coal. Already, the largest coal producer in the United States filed bankruptcy last year because coal is now more expensive than solar and wind energy. And solar energy right now takes about 16% of the energy from the sun and converts it to electricity. They now have panels that will up that to 60%, and now oil and gas drop out of the picture. This is going to change our world as well, because the poorest countries in the world are the hottest countries in the world. So we will put solar energy in their communities in Africa and South America, and they will then produce clean water. Once you have free power or cheap power and clean water, you can now take people out of poverty. You can now make them producers. If you give them 3D printers and artificial intelligence and robotics, you can now make them productive people. That's why the market is going up today. The next reason that the market is going up today is because of the coronavirus. And that is because our country and the world has said we need to keep the economy going, and we are pumping $6 trillion into this stock market that is continuing to go up. Now, I want you to look at a chart of the last time we did this, and this was in 2009 through 2018, and see what it did to the stock market. Now, I was one of the people who said, this can't go on, and that's why I got to cash last October and said, this whole thing's going to explode. It would not have exploded if it were not the corona crisis, and I will explain to it, and I, like a fool, would be still sitting in cash. But as it is, I was able to take advantage of the drop in the stock prices as a result of the corona crisis. But nonetheless, the market skyrocketed as from 2009 through 2018. We took the national debt from $8 trillion to $18 trillion, pumping $10 trillion into the market, and you can see where it went. It went right to the stock market. Now we're doing the same thing. We're pumping $3 trillion, and we're considering another $3 to bring it to $6 into the market within 60 to 90 days. There will probably be another $3 or $4 trillion, and we'll match the $10 that we did before year's end. But you're saying, yes, but that money has to be paid back. No, it does not. No, it does not. We have yet to pay back the money that we borrowed to finance World War II. We have yet to pay back the $10 trillion that we borrowed to bring us out of the subprime crisis. We will not be in any rush to pay this money back. Why, you say? Why wouldn't we be in a rush to pay it back? Anytime interest rates are lower than the profit that you make off of that borrowed money, there is no reason to pay it back, and there is no reason not to pay more or borrow more. We have a current interest rate of less than 1%. Now, in the old economy, when businesses had a margin of 2%, it was questionable. But in today's economy, where companies like Apple and Amazon and Google and Facebook and IBM and Microsoft have a margin of anywhere from 10 to 15%, and they can borrow money for 2%, why wouldn't they? There is no reason. Why would they pay it back? There is no reason. So this will go on as long as interest rates stay down. But you say, with all this money coming into the economy, interest rates are going to go up because it's going to cause inflation. Look back at the last 10 trillion in the last 10 years and tell me if it caused inflation. No, it has caused deflation because technology has made everything so much more efficient that we haven't had inflation. Oh, we've had some inflation in a few areas, but not overall. And I do not see that we're going to have inflation in the future because all of these, eight items I just gave you is going to make our economy that much more efficient. And so interest rates will stay down, inflation will stay down, and the market will continue to go up. The next reason, and the final reason, number 12, is Moore's Law. Moore's Law says that Moore was the CEO of Intel, and he made a statement a number of years ago that the computing power is doubling every 18 months. Well, it is actually doubling in a shorter span of time now. And within that 10 years that I gave you, the computing power will tenfold surpass the computing power of my mind. And as a result, we will then enter into machine learning. Much as I learned as a child, and I gathered information and then made, through logic, future decisions based on that information, computers will go there after we achieve all this. So the computing power, when we add that with quantum computing, will surpass the ability of the human mind. The things that are going to happen in your lifetime are just going to, as I said, you will look back at 2020 the same way you look at 1900 today. This is why the stock market is going up. So our question as investors, as members of the tribe, Best of Us Investors.com. And if you haven't registered, please register so I can forward you additional information. The winners of the past revolution from 2010 to 2020 were Amazon, Google, Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, and IBM. They will be the winners in the next 10 years as well because they control the data. They have a leg up on everyone else. We as investors have added, for my benefit, some other companies we need to look at. Nikola, which Previs brought to our attention. I believe Uber, which is going to change as a result of the transportation revolution. There is no reason I should have $200,000 of depreciating assets sitting in my garage that I only use 5% of my lifetime. I should not own a car. I should rent a car, or I should have someone pick me up and take me where I want to go in an autonomous automobile. Then we have Tesla, which has been brought and pushed home by Homer. And Homer, I am now a proud shareholder in Tesla. Then we had NVIDIA, which Igor brought to our attention, a gaming company that I think is going to have some far reaches into the world of virtual reality and augmented reality. Then you can't look past Netflix. Net has changed the entertainment industry and now is becoming one of the largest content producers in the world. The next video I'm going to do is how your world is going to change, and we're going to dig deeper into how education, how health, how entertainment, how transportation is going to be so different in the very near future. And then we're going to do one on the specific 5G investments you should be looking at for 2020 through 2021. If this is the kind of video you like, subscribe. Please give us a thumbs up. It helps the algorithm. Go to bestofusinvestors.com, register so we can share our information with you.